In this special episode from Regeneration Who 2, we speak with Osgood from Doctor Who. On Cosplay with Constance, a Jedi faces off against a stormtrooper in a trivia battle. Then, our Osgood cosplayer plays Doctor Who villain charades with members of our audience. Tiki Twoflower gives a valuable cosplay tip about removing makeup. We meet the cosplayer behind Osgood, who is also a cooking nerd. Finally, a bonus interview with Jim Tavaré, who is in Harry Potter and is a stand-up comedian. Suit up. It's time for some cosplay. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Captain Kyle's Cosplay Spotlight. We are taping this episode at Regeneration Who 2. And today we have a guest who is a friend of a Time Lord known as the Doctor, an ally, and we think might be human. I'd like to introduce to you Osgood. Welcome to the show. Give her a big round of applause. Make some noise.
Make some noise.
So, the big question is, which one are you, human or Zygon?
What are you talking about?
Which one are you? Are you the human one?
Who are you with?
I'm with Captain Kyle's Cosplay Spotlight. Didn't you just hear that intro? So, I understand that's a question you really don't like to answer, which one you are.
I'm Osgood.
I guess that's good that you're Osgood. Now, Osgood, you work for U.N.I.T.
Yes.
What do you do there?
I am a scientist at U.N.I.T., and I'm also the assistant to Kate.
What part of science you do assisting Kate?
All of it.
All of it?
Yes.
All kinds of sciencey stuff?
Yes, all kinds of sciencey stuff. Wibbly wobbly.
Wibbly wobbly. You seem to be wearing a lot of accoutrements of the Doctor. How long have you been a fan of the Doctor?
Oh, a very long time.
Like, when did you first encounter the Doctor?
That's classified.
But I have to ask, are you now, or have you ever been, a member of the group called Linda?
Do what?
The London Investigation and Detective Agency. Okay, I guess we're going into interesting territory. I understand that there are two of you walking around.
I'm sorry, that's classified.
Don't worry, no one is going to watch this video. I don't get that many views. It's fine. Now, hypothetically...
Wait, why are there cameras here?
Pay no attention to the cameras over here. This is not a video interview for a cosplay talk show. No, no. Yeah, anyway. Hypothetically, if there were two of you, and one of you was a Zygon and one of you was human... Hypothetically, so we're not going into classified territory.
How do you know about Zygons? Who have you been talking to?
My neighbor's a Zygon. Seriously. We play cards against humanity all the time. They particularly like the against humanity part.
So what you're telling me is you live next door to a Zygon.
Yes, I do.
Then they're breaking the pact because they're not supposed to look like a Zygon.
Well, they don't normally. Only
on... Then how do you know they're a Zygon?
Well...
How do I know you're not a Zygon?
That's true. You don't know that I'm not a Zygon. Well, hypothetically, as you're a sciencey person, if there was a hypothetical alien species known as Zygons who could change shape and could affix to a host, and that host got a zit, would the Zygon then get a zit?
I don't know. I've never thought of that. Do Zygons go through puberty? I don't know.
Well, what I'm talking about is reflective nature. You get a zit, your Zygon counterpart gets a zit. Or would they be zitless? Do they have better clearasil?
I don't know. I guess maybe they have better beauty products on where they're from.
Have you ever gotten a zit?
I have.
You have?
Yes.
So you're the human one?
I don't know, am I?
Classified. So, I understand that you turned down a great opportunity. It must have been very terrible. Would you want to be a companion of the Doctor?
Of course. It's the Doctor. I like the Doctor. I mean...
I wouldn't have guessed. Just
no, I know.
You know. So you're mad at me for knowing about the Zygons, but you're not apparently mad at me for knowing about the Doctor.
Well, of course you know about the Doctor. A lot of people know about the Doctor.
Especially if they're in Linda. But the last time the Doctor was around, he offered to bring you along. Why didn't you go with the Doctor?
Because I have important work here at U.N.I.T.
Like doing what? Like bringing some coffee? Do you bring her coffee?
Sometimes. I'm not proud of it.
Do you at least use a scientific method to make the coffee?
I use a Keurig.
That's sciencey enough for me. You are a rather important individual. You mentioned the pact. Not that anyone here knows anything about a pact between a hypothetical alien race called the Zygons and the humans. But hypothetically, what would you be in charge of in regards to the pact?
That's classified.
I guess I'm just pressing your buttons. Anyways. She wants to hit my buzzer. Well, it looks like this is all the time we have for right now. Especially since you keep on saying it's classified.
Sorry. That's classified too.
But we will be back. We're going to go to another segment, and we will be back with some fun and games.
Oh, I like games.
I think you're going to like this one. We'll be back shortly.
Hi everyone, this is Cosplay with Constance, and we are here at Garden State Comic Fest to pit Stormtrooper against Jedi in a battle of wits and trivia. I wanted a battle to the death, but I was told not allowed, blood, gore, not allowed, family friendly, etc. And are you guys ready to go?
Definitely.
Okay, let's see. First question. What is the name of Luke's friend who left Tatooine and meets up with Luke right before the Battle of Yavin?
That'd be Biggs Darklighter.
Yes, one answer, 1 point for the Jedi. Now, Stormtrooper. Name the rebel pilot who was present at all the major battles of episodes 4, 5, and 6 as a member of the Red Squadron.
Dax? Dax?
No, it's we were looking for Wedge Antilles.
Wedge,
yes. Question number two for you. What planet is Han Solo from?
Corellia.
Correct. 2 points for the Jedi. What was the name... Oh, Stormtrooper, I should address you. What was the name of the planet Princess Leia gave Grand Moff Tarkin as a location of the Rebel base?
Dantooine.
The Rebel planet's on Dantooine. Sorry, yes. What is the name of Greedo's species?
Rodian.
Correct. On which planet was Anakin Skywalker defeated by Obi-Wan Kenobi and left to burn?
That lava planet.
You're so close.
It started with an M.
Yes, but there's more letters. There's like six more letters. I believe in you.
Not Mustafar.
That's it. Yeah, that's Mustafar. It. Yeah. Jedi, what is the species of the creature that Luke Skywalker's fought at Jabba's palace?
Rancor.
Correct.
He's getting the easy
jokes
one.
There. You're up. You guys are like even now, man.
Rebel scum.
What rebel leader is well known for shouting the warning, "It's a trap!" at the Battle of Endor?
Admiral Ackbar.
See, that's an easy one. Come on. What planet is Chewbacca from?
That would be Kashyyyk.
Correct. Last question, see if you guys tie or if you're letting the Jedi win. What medicinal substance is used to treat serious injuries? As a Stormtrooper gazes at Kyle and murder gaze for his questions.
Aloe vera?
No, I'll give you one more guess. If you have a guess.
Wormwood?
No, we have the answer Bacta. Is that how you pronounce it? I think so, right? Yeah.
Good triumphs
over evil again. Jedi wins 5 points of four. Thank you both for playing. It's been fun. It was really freaking close.
Are you saying I missed a few?
You did miss. You missed one. But yeah, you missed. I'm sorry.
Sometimes I miss.
It was right there. You had it, but you missed. Back to you, Kyle.
This episode was sponsored in part by Peppermint Cosplay Knives, your source for high-quality, con-safe replica blades. Visit them today. All right, welcome back. We're going to have a special segment with our cosplayer, Osgood, who is going to be playing a game of charades, but it's Doctor Who-based. We have a couple of members of our audience here that we have drafted, dragged kicking and screaming from their chairs to put in the front, and they will be actually guessing what Osgood is charading. And the thing is, she is charading Doctor Who villains. And let's see if she can charade her way into telling them what these villains are. And our audience members will get shirts, because that's all we have the budget for. All right, Osgood, take it away.
One word.
Cybermen?
Can we help them, please?
Yeah, please.
Don't. Yeah.
Thank you.
We heard Dalek. Next.
Asakhu.
Cybermen.
There we go. Yeah. Cybermen.
One word.
Zygons.
Zygons! Wait, is that how you with the head of your human or Zygon?
Classified.
Classified, okay.
Slavine?
Wow. I was going to say you need to call pregnant, but you know.
That's what I thought.
Two words. Empty child?
Moist.
Lady Cassandra.
Oh. Yeah, that's all I got. Okay. So let's skip that one for a second.
Clockwork robots?
Weepy Angel?
Autons?
We'll take Autons.
Okay.
Living plastic, that's the answer, just miss all that.
Weeping Angel.
That one was way too easy.
Missing.
That one was way too easy, too.
Silence. Oh, he got it, too.
Yeah, that one was kind of easy, actually.
Centaurs?
Wow. Good job, boy. All right, we'll be back with the cosplayer after this. Thanks so much.
Hi, I'm Tiki Twoflower, and welcome to Cosplay Tips with Tiki. Today, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about taking off makeup. So, almost any makeup that you can wear, whether it's something that's really natural or you have like full body makeup on, is going to come off best with good old soap, water, and a washcloth. But what if you are changing from one costume to another, or maybe you're going out after the con and you don't feel like having your entire face painted, but you also don't have time to go back to your hotel? Well, there is a miraculous product out there called makeup removing wipes. These are pre-moistened towelettes that have makeup remover in them. I've heard of a lot of cosplayers using baby wipes for this purpose, which
kind of works. Baby wipes are designed to clean skin, but they're not designed specifically to take off your makeup. So these wipes will work on any level of makeup. You just might have to use more than one if you do have like a full colored face, but they work really quickly and easily. So you can get all that makeup off really easily with a makeup removing wipe. And like I said, I had a simple face of makeup on, so it came off pretty quickly. It's gonna take you a little bit longer with a full face of makeup, but you can take your makeup off on the go pretty easily. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.
So welcome back to our special taping of Captain Kyle at Regeneration Who 2. And I would like to introduce to you someone who is actually not a member of UNIT. They're not. Their name is not actually Osgood. In fact, would you introduce yourself to our audience here?
Hi, everyone. My name is Angela, also known as Star Angel Costuming.
Awesome.
Yay. They like me. They really like me.
Well, thank you so much for coming on to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Even though everything's classified.
Yes, everything is classified. No, not really.
So, do you do a lot of cosplays?
I do do a lot of cosplays.
I see you kind of like, I'm getting the impression, I'm going on a limb, you like Doctor Who?
I do like Doctor Who. I mean, I thought I was at a Star Wars convention this weekend, but it seems
It's not Battlestar Galactica?
Yeah, I know. Like, there's Zygons, or not Zygons, but Cylons outside.
Wait,
those are Cybermen. Oops.
So, what do you do? Well, first of all, what other cosplays do you have?
Oh, wow. I have a lot of cosplays. I've made over 100 in the last 17 years. I've done a Clockwork Android from The Girl in the Fireplace. I've done lots of Japanese animation costumes. I've done original stuff. I actually have a really cute TARDIS yukata dress that I like to run around in at conventions. I've done Nurse Chapel from Star Trek. I've done Princess Leia from Star Wars. Lots of stuff.
Wow. Sounds like we would need like an extra episode just to list all your costumes. So.
Yeah, probably. I'd have to like write them all down or...
I hear you.
Look online. See all the pictures.
Do you have a life outside of cosplay? What do you do outside of cosplay?
Outside of cosplay, I am a writer, an actress, a special effects makeup artist, and a school teacher.
Wow.
I do a lot of stuff. I have no free time ever.
So a school teacher. So
yes.
So you deal with a lot of younger, what kind of age group do you deal with?
I have taught kindergarten through 12th grade band, orchestra, and elementary music.
Wow. Now do they know about your cosplay habit?
Some of them do.
So what do those who know about your cosplay hobby? What do they say about it? Do they think it's cool? Do they think you're a weirdo who goes around in cosplay and dresses in costume at your age?
Oh, no, they like it. I have a lot of kids that are in the anime club at the school that I work at that think it's really cool. Or we have a couple of girls in one of the classes that I worked in that we got into Doctor Who. And so for Last from the Past Day, she came dressed as the 10th Doctor with the 3D glasses.
Very cool.
That was really fun.
So this is what is influencing our children.
Yes!
I'd say that's a cosplay win. Absolutely. What would you say to someone just getting into cosplay who wanted to join the ranks of these cosplayers?
Just pick a character you like and do it. It's awesome. It's fun. You can be as creative as you want. You don't have to hand make everything. Your first costume does not have to be super marvelous. It just has to be something that you love.
What do you think about people who buy their costumes rather than actually make them or
modify? They're there to have fun too. So, I mean, buying your costume from someone, if you can't sew, then that's an option.
I can't sew. Awesome. You said you like Star Wars and Star Trek. What's like the weirdest fandom you have?
I have this really, really weird issue with writing fandom cookbooks. So, like, I'm a cooking nerd, too? Is that a fandom?
I guess it can be. Sounds delicious to me.
Yeah.
So, you've actually written some fandom cookbooks?
I have written 2 unofficial Doctor Who cookbooks.
Unofficial Doctor Who cookbooks?
Unofficial. I have to say that. I don't want to get sued.
So, how did you name them? You called them the unofficial Doctor Who cookbooks?
They're actually based off of Series 8 and Series 9 of Capaldi's run. And so, they're called Shut Up and Eat and Shut Up and Eat 2. First one's the unofficial Series 8 cookbook. Haha, wordplay. 8's not a number. And the second one is Shut Up and Eat 2, the unofficial Doctor Who Series 9 Ready to Dine cookbook.
Ooh.
I like puns.
And poetry. Where can we find these cookbooks?
Well, you can find them on Amazon.
That is awesome. That sounds like a yummy endeavor.
It is a very yummy endeavor.
And where can people find you on social media?
Twitter at angelise.com.
Instagram?
Same.
MySpace?
No.
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 Me neither.
No.
Okay.
No,
Mr. Superman,
no,
not here.
No, Mr.
No.
Kyle, no.
No, no, no,
no.
No MySpace or Mr. Superman.
No.
Well, it's been lovely having you on the show. I'm going to actually go to another segment.
Okay.
I don't even know what it is yet. We'll take a look. And we'll be back to wish our audience a fond farewell.
Okay.
So we'll be back. Thanks so much.
Geek Girls Castle has nerdy skirts with a drawstring waist and large pockets that fit an iPhone 6 Plus, plus drawstring bags for dice, makeup, electronics, and more. Check them out at geekgirlscastle.com.
Hi, everybody. This is Captain Kyle. I'm at the Winter Pop and Comic Wonderland. I'm here with Jim Tavaré, who is in Harry Potter, a number of horror films, and he's an awesome stand-up comedian. How are you enjoying the con today, Jim?
Absolutely wonderful gig. Having a great time. Met some wonderful people, as usual. I really feel at home with these things, and I just could be here. I could just spend a week here, I think, and just really nice people down here. Where are we, by the way?
We're in Waynesboro, PA.
It's always been one of my favorite places, Waynesboro. So I want to come back again.
So you do a lot of conventions?
I tend to be the Harry Potter guy in the United States, because there's not many of us. So yeah, I live in LA now. I moved to California, to Hollywood, 8 years ago to realize my dreams of being an Uber driver. And I do some acting on the side as well, so...
I think we all have this inner desire to be an Uber driver.
Yeah, you recognize me? Yeah.
So at these cons, you look around and you see people who are dressed...
Yeah.
Not exactly in what I would call regular street clothing, definitely. There's people dressed as superheroes, people dressed as Star Wars characters, people dressed as Waldo. What do you think of these cosplayer people?
Well, I think they're wonderful. The ones I recognize, which aren't many, obviously, but I think it's very creative, and it's a fantastic outlet. And you can be really important as a cosplay artist. Is that the correct term?
They're definitely considered artists.
I think that it's a very, very fine creative form, and that's how it all starts.
If you were going to come to a con and cosplay, who would you cosplay? And then I have an idea, but let's first see what you would like to cosplay.
Probably Voldemort. I'm trying to give you what you want to hear.
No, I want to hear what you want to say. Who you could be Mary Poppins for all, you know.
My favorite character, I wouldn't have a realistic chance, I think, maybe in another life of playing David Bradley's character in the Harry Potter movies, Fitch. And I would like to do that. I think that's a great character to do. In the past I've always been Frankenstein in Halloween parties, but these days I just go as myself and usually win the prize with my scary animated skull effect. Here it comes.
Okay, that's all we have. No, I'm kidding. that was very impressive. So are there any projects that you're working on right now?
Projects, products,
whatever you want to talk about.
I'm here doing a movie in South Carolina next Thursday. I go for 9 days. So if anyone has any things for me to do in South Carolina, I'd love to hear, because I've never been there before. I'm working in Florence, shooting a family film with dogs and cats. Never worked with animals. I'm doing it for the fifth movie, working with dogs and cats. I have to, like, be the bad henchman, like Home Alone kind of henchman. It's muscle memory job time for me. So I'm doing that right now. And I just did a commercial with Amy Schumer as well for the Old Navy. And that's just played out. That was fun to do, a boxing scenario thing. I talk about commercials. I didn't used to be in, want to be in them, but they really do pay the bills. And so then I can relax and do creative projects.
So where can people find you on social media to follow your projects?
So I'm on JimTavaré, .org, or I'm on Twitter, Jim Tavaré, Facebook, official Jim Tavaré. I'm out there, you know, I'm there.
Well, we'll put the links in the description Thank and you. All that. Well, Jim, that's about all the time we have. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks to the fans for making this such fun. You know, I love being in a different place at a convention. It's like being at home.
Absolutely. Thanks, everyone, for watching, and we'll see you next time. As always, have fun and cosplay on. Well, that's all the show we have for this time, but tune in next time and we'll have some other cosplayers doing other weird stuff, maybe even weirder stuff. But thanks so much for being on the show. You were a good Osgood.
Thank you.
Something like
puns.
That. Puns, yes. So have an Osgood time.
Yes.
And I hope you drive Osgood.
Thank you. I will do my best.
But we'll see you next time. Thanks so much. And as always, have fun. And cosplay on.
Interested in cosplay, but you're not sure where to start? Get my book, Elements of Cosplay, The Costume and Beyond, available at Amazon.com. We hope you enjoyed this episode of Captain Kyle's Cosplay Spotlight. Please like, comment, share, and of course, subscribe. Our next episode features Oron from the video game Final Fantasy. Plus, we'll have a bonus interview with actor Michael Trainor from The Walking Dead. It will be released February 27th at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Thanks for watching. See you next time.